Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk about some graphic design jargon and slang that you might not have heard of, or maybe you have heard of it, but you just didn't know what it means. And I have my husband here today to kind of act as a creative director. All right, let's get started. Above the fold.
We need to make sure that this logo and these elements are above the fold.
Oh. This phrase originally related to newspapers. So after the newspaper was folded, the most important content and designs needed to be above the fold. So on the first page and in the top half. Now it's used to refer mostly to websites. So this is what you see when you first go to the homepage before you start scrolling. Everything you can see on your computer at that point is above the fold. Horsey text.
The text is a little bit horsey to me. You know what I mean?
When someone says the design or text is horsey, they mean that the elements or text are too big. So you should reduce the size. It usually is talking about text though. White space.
Nice job. I'm loving all the white space.
This refers to empty areas of the design that are really used to kind of help balance it. And white space doesn't necessarily have to be white. It can be any color as long as there's nothing important in it. It can even be a photo or part of a background photo. Busy.
This design is just too busy. I hate it.
If your creative director thinks the design is too busy, that means that there are too many things going on in the design. So maybe there are too many different types of fonts. Maybe there are too many colors, or maybe the hierarchy is wrong. Or maybe there just isn't enough white space. Clean.
I don't know. I'm really looking for a clean look.
In clean design, which is really popular right now, there really isn't a whole lot of elements. It's very functional. There's not a lot of flourishes, if that makes sense. Dynamic.
Can we make it more dynamic? It's just not dynamic enough.
We as designers usually kind of hate getting feedback like this because we don't really know what that means. I would guess that the creative director just didn't really like the design, but didn't know how to put a finger on what it was he didn't like about it. And clients do this too. So the design might have hierarchy issues, font issues, color issues. Maybe one thing is not being focused on enough. CMYK.
Can we make sure this design is in CMYK?
CMYK stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. And these are the four colors that make up printed design. RGB.
These ads look kind of dull. Can you check to make sure they're in RGB?
RGB stands for red, green, and blue. And these are the colors that are made up of light. So anytime you see a screen, you're looking at RGB colors. And if you put CMYK colors on the web, they can tend to look really weird, even if they look good on your screen before uploading. Content.
Go get the ad content from Diane.
This usually means the text for an ad, but it could also include the writer's ideas about what graphics should go along with it. And it usually comes to you in the form of like a Microsoft Word document or a Google Doc. Copywriter.
Go back to one of the copywriters so they can tweak things to make it fit a little better in the space.
A copywriter is someone who writes all the text for your designs. So this could be web design, it might be magazine ads. Your copywriter is the one to write it. This has nothing to do with copyright, which is a legal term. And this term is actually spelled differently too. Cooler.
Can we go with a cooler palette on this one?
If someone's asking to make the designs cooler, you're going to want to use more greens, blues, and purples because those are on the cooler side of the color wheel. Warmer.
Have you tried warmer colors in this design?
The warmer side of the color wheel are the reds, the yellows, and the oranges. DPI and PPI.
This logo looks blurry. Can you see if there's a version with a higher DPI?
DPI stands for dots per inch and is used in printing. And PPI stands for pixels per inch and is used on screens. Most people use DPI, which is the original, even though they may be talking about DPI or PPI, you probably shouldn't correct them. Budget creep.
We're actually getting some budget creep on this project, so hold off on any more changes.
Budget creep might be something that happens when you put way too much time and effort into a design and your company starts losing money on it. Flat.
I don't know. This design just kind of feels flat.
If someone says it looks flat, this is kind of like dynamic, where they just don't really know what they don't like about it, maybe. There are probably some hierarchy issues or color issues. FPO.
Can you just put some FPO images in for now?
Sure. FPO means for position only, and it's basically fake placeholder images that you put in your design so that you can just switch them out with the real image later. When I'm using FPO images in my designs, I always put FPO over the picture. Frankensteining.
It looks like the old designer Frankenstein this logo together.
Now, this is really a pretty negative word. We as designers don't like to Frankenstein things together, but sometimes we're asked to do that. So it means taking parts of a few existing designs or logos and kind of putting them together into a new design. And it usually looks worse than it started out. Greek.
Hey, we don't have content for this brochure yet, so just Greek it.
Oh. This means to add fake text while you're waiting for the real text to come in. Usually I use lorem ipsum, which is kind of a fake language that looks like English, but is completely meaningless. Hamburger menu.
Can you make the hamburger menu smaller?
These are the little menus that you see usually on mobile devices, and they're three horizontal lines. Infographic.
Can you make this into an infographic?
I think I can. An infographic is taking text and making it more visual. You would use the same information that you got in text format and make it into a graphic. Internal customers.
Can we just add purple and yellow to this to make our internal customers happy?
Yeah. These are the people at your company who will see and review the design before it goes to the client. You have to make the internal customers happy first. Now, how about you? Have you come across any slang or jargon in your own job that really threw you for a loop? If you did, leave it in the comment section below. And I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you. Okay, I think that's it.
All right.